else. So if you confuse your reader too much by making something that they can't understand, you're losing them for even just a few moments. You don't want to do that. It's like those times in movies that aren't quite made all that well, where you start to fall asleep. In fact, that's because the filmmaker is not holding your attention, because you no longer are relating to what you're looking at on screen. Comics are no different. Okay, so there's a little demon guy. Now, I'm going to put him in Jackie's hand. And give his little tail. And here's the comic book hands. That's okay, I'm professional. Let me just grab another pen. Again, Jackie's hands are kind of pointy, so I can give him these really aggressive nails. And you indicate the knuckles right there. Again, it's for perspective, because everyone knows what hands look like. Even if they can't draw them, they know what they look like. And they can tell, wow, that hand kind of sucks. Did not know how to draw that hand. So as advice to people that want to get into comics, as illustrators, hands are something that you really do need to know how to draw. Learn how to draw. Pick your targets. Learn how to draw hands, because you're going to need that skill. His hands are very, very expressive, and they can actually help you with your character's acting. That's another aspect of comic art. That's he's sitting in Jackie's hand. There's Jackie's arm right there to show the connection. I'm going to give this guy his tail. And in this case, his tail kind of helps me anyway with the composition there. It kind of has that little shape going off there. And this is all going to be kind of dark, I think, down here. And it's going to help pop his fingers. There we go. Put that in there. Give him these bat wings. Who doesn't love bat wings? Now, everything I need, all the information is there. All right. So all I got to do now is make things pop. And people watching may not think some change is a big deal, but to the artist that's drawing it at that moment, it is. It can literally change the direction of a piece entirely. And just indicated right there, his other cheekbone. For the most part, this whole half of Jackie's face is going to be black. But I'm going to indicate a few spots so that the reader or the person looking at it can get the idea that that there's symmetry to his face beneath that, beneath the dark areas. Again, that. Okay. All right. You'll see that I'm going to kind of do some freelancing stuff that wasn't there, even with that last section of adding lines with the ink pen. I'm just going to add some more stuff that I think will look good and add form using the positive and negative technique. And again, positive space being the black line, negative space being the white line. Sometimes the negative space, which is the white line, is even though you don't touch that part of the paper, that's drawing. You kind of start to see that there's a light source here. This little demon, as I add black to this, I'm going to make sure that he really stands out. That may require me adding white out afterwards. We'll have to see as we get there. Sometimes I don't even know until I get to that point. In my head right now, I may use white out, I may not. I'll know when I get there. A couple of wisps of hair. I might even use some white out on the hair later too, we'll see. Okay. You can kind of kind of see how these demons are coming together. Gnarly right in here, like tree trunks. Give a lot of interesting texture. And again, because we were working in a 2D medium, things like texture actually can add to the movement. And you'll notice that I'm drawing in a certain direction. And that's because I want to follow the movement of these snakes' heads and stuff like that more when there's black behind them. And I'm going to keep doing that as I move forward to finish off the piece. And I think I'd actually like to show this guy a little bit more. So I'm gonna go in and put a little bit more black behind there to kind of pop the lower part of his face a little bit there. Okay. Same thing here. And I'm gonna speed things up a little bit just so you guys don't run out of patience. Alrighty. Let's try this nib here. Alright, so how about we do this guy before I go into Jackie's face? I'm gonna pop some black into this guy. Define him a little bit more. And he's kind of small, so I'm probably gonna go in there with a pen. But I'm gonna hit some of the bigger black spots right now with this brush. Jackie's neck, his face. You can see there. See how that kind of works? That directional stuff. And again, that, rather than putting in solid black, which is great, and you know, a lot of people do that. A lot of artists just put solid black in for stuff like that. It kind of goes back to that whole energy thing for me. You know, when you have line work like this, there's a certain energy that's added. You know, a certain immediacy to the line or to the piece that kind of makes it a little more exciting. Okay, and here's, again, I'm gonna follow the form of Jackie's impressive pectoral muscles. This is comic books. That's being cast. And there's his shoulder over there, which I will, as I move forward, I'll define that a little bit more. But you'll also see I'm going to start using this black back here to help pop this demon even more to this guy. You know, it's going on to Jackie there, but now I'm adding to this guy some weight and some depth. There's a shadow being cast on Jackie's hand, so it gives you a real feeling that this guy is seated in Jackie's palm. And he's got a little, like I said, he's got a little bit of a gut there. Not all demons are in shape. Going to indicate some black there. I may or may not go in there and add black. I'll have to see how it's going. Okay, back there. Now I'm going to kind of go in and help pop Jackie's fingers out a little bit by going in there and blackening in his arm beneath it. See how that just pops his hands out a little bit? There. Now what I'm going to do, I think, making his areas, even in the black, kind of creepy and scary. It's kind of all direction of line, seeing what needs to be accentuated, what needs to not be, kind of just following the contours of like the human face, even though he's wearing this mask. It's kind of form-fitting. And again, it's about making him creepy. Just gonna make sure that there's a separation between his face and his neck. In the case of Jack, I mean, he should kind of scare you when he looks at you. Not all comic book characters do that. But in Jackie's case, it's kind of his calling card. I'm going to go in there right now. And I'm going to take some white out here. And just kind of help define a little bit better his jawline. So it separates from his neck. It's really that simple. And I'm going to go in there a little bit more afterwards. But right there, I needed to make sure that I was doing the right thing. So I went to the whiteout before I usually do. And I'm going to kind of shape his forehead here. And again, it's in shadow. And keeping in mind the shape of a person's face, the planes of the forehead, the brow. And doing some cross-hatching here. And all cross-hatching is a grayscale line. Is by adding some creepy dark areas to the background. And I think, again, with movement, even though what I'm doing right now aren't serpents, it's just black, or rather it's just the dark background, I'm going to kind of go with the movements, which also is a part of, you know, it's again, it's like his power.
It's the energy thing.
Because and his demons,
as I go along,
his power,
you'll see,
comes out of dark, hence darkness. That this really is just fancy and kind of to help pop everything out.
Following interesting shapes
here. I'm following this kind of rotation movement here. And plus, I want to kind of come in near the end of the piece, accentuate the light.
I'm not
going to
concern myself right now too much with
by making things behind me and dark, making it super clean and being anal retentive. I just really want to get the feeling
that makes any sense
of the darkness right now. He's really kind of going in there. And I'll pick out things only because I wanted to find them just a little bit more. You know, again, I'm not trying to be anal retentive. I'm not trying to overwork it. I just want the immediate clarity that when someone looks at it, they don't have to think about it to know that there's these shapes and there's like these monsters. Now, when you render things a lot, and I like to render things, the key is keep it clear so that the initial impression is very obvious. You know exactly what you're looking at, but later on, if someone really wanted to, they could look at it as an illustration and go, oh, these are kind of cool details that I didn't pay attention to before because I was busy reading the comic book. But they can kind of go back and go, oh, that's pretty cool. So, you know, when you do things like this, these lines, it's not because I want the reader to look at every single line I'm drawing, just the opposite. You know, I'm using these lines to give an impression. You know, like impressionistic painters, you know, which I was a big fan of. I didn't really like to see things defined for me too clearly.